Hi students, good morning everybody. Today I am going to explain how to find the derivatives of standard functions using fundamental principle or first principle or definition. Okay, so when do we say that a function is differentiable or derivable? If limit h tends to 0, f of x plus h minus f of x by h exists, then we say that f is differentiable function or derivable function with respect to x. Clear? It is denoted by f dash x or d of f of x or simply y dash, or we say that y1, or dy by dx. Okay, so this can be written as like this: f dash x equal to limit h tends to 0, f of x plus h minus f of x upon h. This is called first principle or fundamental principle or definition of the differentiable function. Okay, if this limit exists, limit h tends to 0, f of x plus h minus f of x upon h exists, then we say that f is differentiable function or derivable function with respect to x. It is denoted by f dash x, d of f of x, or y dash, or y1, or dy by dx. Dy by dx means what? Differentiation of derivative of y with respect to x. Y is dependent variable and x is independent variable. Okay, so by using this formula, let us see how to find the derivatives of some standard functions. Okay, for that I need to have some standard limits also here. Limit theta tends to 0, sin theta by theta value 1, limit of sin theta by theta as theta tends to 0, value how much? 1. Or you can have limit theta by sin theta as theta tends to 0, also 1. Okay, similarly, limit tan theta by theta as theta tends to 0, or limit theta by tan theta as theta tends to 0, value also 1. And limit e power x minus 1 by x as x tends to 0, value 1. Limit of a power x minus 1 by x as x tends to 0 is log a to the base e. Okay, similarly, limit of 1 plus 1 by x whole power x as x tends to infinity, value e. E means an irrational number, standard formula. Okay, e means it lies between 2 and 3, approximately 2.713. it is an irrational number. Okay, just remember that. Similarly, limit of 1 plus 1 by x as whole power x as x tends to minus infinity also no problem. Value e limit 1 plus x whole power 1 by x as x tends to 0, value also e. Okay, these are the standard formulas we use, and particularly we use sin c plus sin d transformations. 2 sin c plus d by 2 into cos c minus d by 2. This you must remember. Sin c minus sin d equal to 2 cos c plus d by 2 sin c minus d by 2. Similarly, cos c plus cos d 2 cos c plus d by 2 cos c minus d by 2. Cos c minus cos d minus 2 sin c plus d by 2 sin c minus d by 2. These are the standard formulae we are going to use in the derivatives. Okay, and the multiple and submultiple angles also we will use. At that time I'll tell you. Okay, so try to understand this. Clear? Okay, find the derivative of, first we will find the derivatives of trigonometric functions. Find the derivative of, find the derivative of sin x using first principle or fundamental principle or definition. Okay, let me see. First let me take f of x equal to sin x. What is f of x plus h? Sin of x plus h. We have, what is the formula for first definition? F dash x equal to limit f of x plus h minus f of x upon h. This is the first principle or fundamental principle. Limit h tends to 0. What is f of x plus h? Sin of x plus h minus sin x upon h. Limit h tends to 0. See, it looks like sin c minus sin d. What is the formula for sin c minus sin d? 2 cos c plus d by 2 into sin c minus d by 2. Okay? Upon h. Okay? Sin c minus sin d, just I told you before, 2 cos c plus d by 2 and sin c minus d by 2, plus x minus x gets cancelled. Limit h tends to 0, 2 cos x plus x 2x plus h by 2 into sin h by 2 is remaining here, and this h I am keeping for this. Okay, so here what is remaining? Limit h tends to 0, 2 cos, this you can split, 2x by 2 means x plus h by 2 into, limit I am writing for this also, limit h tends to 0 sin h by 2 by h. As I told you earlier, limit sin theta by theta as theta tends to 0, value how much? 1, standard limit. So is it in that form? Sin theta by theta. So in the place of theta we have h by 2, but you have only h here. So by 2 I am taking, by 2 and into 2 I am taking. Multiply and divide. Limit h tends to 0 means h by 2 tends to also 0. Divide both sides by 2. Okay. Then this 2 and 2 gets cancelled. Then I will apply limit now. Cos x plus in the place of h keep 0. So here this value will be 1 because it is a standard limit. Okay. Limit theta tends to 0. Sin theta by theta value how much? 1. So what is remaining here? Cos x. So therefore f dash x equal to what? Cos x. That is d by dx of sin x is equal to cos x. Is that clear? So derivative of sin x is what? Cos x. Derivative of sin x is cos x. Let us see second one. Cos x derivative. That is the standard limit, you remember always. Find the derivative of second one, cos x, using first principle. f of x equal to cos x, f of x plus h means cos of x plus h, formula I wrote. So limit h tends to 0 cos x plus h minus cos x upon h. Limit h tends to 0. Cos c minus cos d formula. What is cos c minus cos d formula? I told you. Cos c minus cos d formula minus 2 sin c plus d by 2 into sin c minus d by 2. Right? So minus 2 sin c plus d by 2 into sin c minus d by 2 upon h. Okay. Limit h tends to 0 minus 2 sin x plus x, 2x plus h by 2 into here x gets cancelled. Sin h by 2 upon this h I am keeping here. So next step I will take limit h tends to 0 minus 2 sin 2x by 2 means x plus h by 2. Limit I will apply for here also, limit h tends to 0 sin h by 2 by h is there. Just before I told you, if this is h by 2, then here also h by 2 should be there. Multiply and divide it to 2 and h by 2 tends to 0. This value will be how much? 2 to cancel. So minus you keep it outside, sin x plus 0, and this value will become as 1 because standard limit. Limit theta tends to 0, sin theta by theta value how much? 1. So what is remaining here? Minus sin x. So what is the derivative of cos x? Therefore f dash x equal to cos x. Sorry. Minus sin x. So that is d by dx of cos x. Derivative of cos x is minus sin x. So what is the derivative of cos x with respect to x? Sin x minus sin x. Okay. Let us see third one, tan x. third one. Third one, tan x. Okay. F of x equal to tan x tan of x plus h limit h tends to 0 tan of x plus h minus tan x upon h limit h tends to 0 tan of x plus h can I write like this sin of x plus h by cos of x plus h sin tan theta is nothing but sin theta by cos theta minus tan x is nothing but sin x by cos x upon h. Take LCM now. What will you get? Sin of x plus h into cos x minus cos of x plus h into sin x upon h cos of x plus h into cos x. Okay, now numerator, see, it looks like sin a cos b minus cos a sin b. Can I write sin of a minus b sin of a minus b by h cos of x plus h into cos x? Okay, sin a cos b minus cos a sin b equal to sin a minus b. Plus x minus x gets cancelled. So what is remaining here? Limit h tends to 0. Sin h by h write together. Limit h tends to 0. 1 by cos x plus h into cos x. Clear? For both I apply limit. This value will be 1, standard limit, no? Limit theta tends to 0, sin theta by theta value 1. So this value will be 1. Into here, if I apply limit, cos x into cos x. How much? Cos square x. What is 1 by cos square x? Secant square x. So therefore, f dash x equal to secant square x. That is, d by dx of tan x. What is the derivative of tan x here? Secant square x. Derivative of tan x is what? Secant square x. And secant square x integration is tan x. Reverse. Both are reciprocal to each other. Okay? Let us see cot. Cot x derivative. Same model. Cot x derivative. Find the derivative of fourth one. Cot x. Cot x. Cot of x plus h. So limit h tends to 0, cot of x plus h minus cot x upon h. Limit h tends to 0, cot means, can I write cos by sin? Before we had tan, so sin by cos. Now cot means cos by sin minus cot x means cos x by sin x upon h. Limit h tends to 0. I can write here LCM. Sin a cos b minus cos a sin b. It looks like sin a cos b minus cos a sin b, right? Sin a minus b I can write. So h as it is. What is LCM here? Sin x plus h into sin x. So numerator looks like sin a cos b minus cos a sin b. That means can I write sin a minus b? X minus h upon h into sin x plus h into sin x. Is that clear? It looks like sin a cos b minus cos a sin b. Sin a minus b we can write. Xx gets cancelled. So what is remaining here? Limit h tends to 0 sin minus h by h into sin x plus h into sin x. By the way, what is sin minus h value? Minus sin h, so minus I can keep outside. Limit h tends to 0 sin h by h together. Next remaining, limit h tends to 0 1 by sin x plus h into sin x. So this value will be 1. Standard limit now. Limit theta tends to 0 sin theta by theta value 1. So we can write 1. So in the place of h, if you keep 0, 1 by sin x into sin x sin square x. By the way, what is 1 by sin square x? Right, cos x square x. So therefore, what is the derivative of cot x? Minus cos x square x. That is d by dx of cot x equal to minus cos x square x. Do you follow? Clear now? Let me find out secant x, fifth one. Fifth one is secant x, right? Fifth one, what is the derivative of secant x? Secant x plus h. Substitute. Limit h tends to 0 secant of x plus h minus secant x upon h. Limit h tends to 0. Secant means can I write 1 by cos? 1 by cos minus 1 by cos x upon h. Limit h tends to 0. It can be written as cos x minus of cos x plus h upon h into cos x plus h into cos x. Right? Now again you see here cos c minus cos d, that's why I wrote there. Cos c minus cos d formula, minus 2 sin c plus d by 2 and sin c minus d by 2. Minus 2 sin c plus d upon 2 into sin c minus d upon 2 by h cos of x plus h into cos x. Here xx gets cancelled, I think so. So what is remaining? Limit h tends to 0 minus 2 sin 2x plus h upon 2 into sin minus h by 2 by h cos x plus h into cos x. Right? Now I'll split here. Limit h tends to 0 minus 2 sin 2x by 2 means x plus h by 2, okay, by cos x plus h cos x, write together. Remaining, what do you have? Limit h by 2 tends to 0. Here I have sin h by 2. That minus also I will bring it out. Here minus you have, plus. Minus sin theta, sin minus theta means minus sin theta. So both will be positive. upon h. Here I want by 2 and into 2, this 2 2 gets cancelled. Then h by 2 tends to 0, so this limit will be 1. So limit h tends to 0, then I can keep the limit here. So sin x upon, what is remaining, cos x into cos x. I'll write cos x into cos x. So I'll write 1 by cos x once, sin x by cos x once. 1 by cos x means secant x, sin x cos x, sin x by cos x means tan x. So what is my derivative here? Secant x into tan x. So what is the derivative of secant x? D by dx of secant x equal to secant x into tan x. Got it? So derivative of secant x is secant x into tan x. Okay? Let us see the derivative of cosecant x. Sixth one, cosecant x, cosecant x, f of x plus h means cosec x plus h. So limit h tends to 0, f of x plus h means what? Cosec x plus h minus cosec x upon h. Limit h tends to 0, cosec means, can I write 1 by sin? Sin of x plus h, cosec x means 1 by sin x upon h. Limit h tends to 0, sin x minus sin of x plus h upon h into sin of x plus h into sin x. Now numerator looks like sin c minus sin d, right? So 2 cos c plus d by 2 into sin c minus d by 2 upon h sin x plus h into sin x, right? Here xx gets cancelled. So what is remaining? Limit h tends to 0, 2 cos 2x plus h upon 2 into sin minus h upon 2, right? Upon h sin x plus h into sin x. Clear? Now 2x by 2 means what? 2x by 2 means x. So limit h tends to 0, 2 cos x plus h by 2 upon sin of x plus h into sin x. Limit h by 2 tends to 0, h tends to 0, then h by 2 also tends to 0, sin h by 2 upon h by 2 into 2, that minus I will keep it outside. Okay, so here this value will be 1, this 2 gets cancelled, then what is remaining? Limit I will put here minus cos x upon sin x into sin x. This value is 1. So minus 1 by sin x write together into cos x by sin x write together. Minus 1 by sin x is what? Cosecant x. Cos by sin is what? Cot x. So what is the derivative of cosecant x? minus cosecant x into cot x. Therefore, f dash x equal to minus cosecant x into cot x. That is, dy dx of cosec x equal to minus cosecant x into cot x. These are the six trigonometric ratios derivatives. Sin x derivative is cos x. Cos x derivative is minus sin x. Tan x is secant square x. Cot x is minus cosec square x. Secant x is secant x tan x. Cosecant x is minus cosecant x into cot x. Okay. Okay. Next one. Let us see the derivative of x, seventh one. Derivative of x using first principle. Okay, what is the function here? X, f of x plus h means x plus h. Limit h tends to 0, x plus h minus x by h. So xx gets cancelled. Limit h tends to 0, h by h, these two also gets cancelled. So limit h tends to 0, 1, that value is 1. So therefore, f dash x equal to 1. That is, d by dx of x. Derivative of x with respect to x is what? 1. Okay. Eighth one. Let us see e power x. What is the derivative of e power x by using first principle? Let me take f of x equal to e power x. F of x plus h equal to e power x plus h. We have first principle is f dash x equal to limit h tends to 0 f of x plus h minus f of x upon h. So limit h tends to 0, what is f of x plus h here? E power x plus h minus e power x upon h. Okay, so limit h tends to 0, can I write like this? E power x into e power h, a power m plus n means a power m into a power n. So limit h tends to 0, this I will take e power x common. So e power h minus 1 by h. E power x I will keep it outside because there is no h in that. Limit h tends to 0, e power h minus 1 by h. Standard limit, that value is 1, so e power x. I told you that limit x tends to 0, e power x minus 1 by x. Limit x tends to 0, e power x minus 1 by x value 1, standard limit. So what is the derivative of? Therefore, f dash x equal to e power x, that is d by dx of e power x is e power x only. So derivative of e power x is e power x only. Okay. Next, let us see the derivative of log x. Derivative of log x. Ninth one. find the derivative of log x using first principle. So log x, log of x plus h, limit h tends to 0, log of x plus h minus log x upon h. Logarithms, we have idea, log a minus log b, it looks like log a minus log b, do you remember? Log a by b, okay, log a minus log b formula, log a by b. So log a by b means what? X plus h by x by h, limit h tends to 0, 1 by h keep it out, log x by x 1, h by x, right? In the logarithms we have one more formula, m log a to the base x equal to log a power m to the base x. This product m can be taken to the power. So we can take limit h tends to 0, log of 1 plus h by x whole power 1 by h. Here I have h by x, here I have 1 by h, so I want x there, so multiply and divide with x. Limit h tends to 0, log of 1 plus h by x, I want reciprocal, no there, so h by x means I want here x by h whole to the power, we can write whole to the power, what is remaining here? 1 by x, okay? So I can put log outside, limit h by x tends to 0, 1 plus h by x whole to the power, whole to the power x by h, okay, whole to the power 1 by x. This value fully I told you e, right? Since limit x tends to 0, 1 plus x whole power 1 by x equal to how much? E. Standard limit I told you, power 1 by x as it is. This 1 by x can be brought again this side, log e to the base e. If there is no base, we will take it as e. So that value is 1. Log e to the base e value 1. So therefore, what is the derivative of log x? 1 by x. That is, d by dx of log x is 1 by x. Clear? Let us see one more. 10th one, find the derivative of root x. Let me see root x. 10th one, find the derivative of root x using first principle. So f of x equal to root x, f of x plus h equal to root of x plus h, okay? So limit h tends to 0, square root of x plus h minus square root of x upon h. So if there is square root functions, what will you do? Rationalize. Square root of x plus h plus root of or x by square root of x plus h plus square root of x. Because rationalizing factor of root x plus h minus root x is root x plus h plus root x, right? So rationalization, a plus b into a minus b, right? A plus b into a minus b, a square minus b square, childhood formulas, h into, right, root of x plus h plus root x. So limit h tends to 0, x plus h minus x upon h into root of x plus h plus root x. Xx gets cancelled. So what is remaining? H by h into root x plus h plus root x. H gets cancelled. Limit h tends to 0, what is remaining? 1 by root x plus h plus root x. So if I put limit there, root x plus root x, how much? 2 root x. Therefore, f dash x equal to 1 by 2 root x. So that is, what is the derivative of root x? 1 by 2 root x. So total 10 functions I told you. We will see some more functions in the next class. Thank you.